It's as if you swallowed a gadfly nest. Keep silent and keep them to yourself, lest you tire yourself before the next campfire. All right, he's done.
Hey.
If Adir has anything else to say. I hope that old watcher's still there. Been years since I heard anything about him. What is it you wanted to ask this watcher in Caer Nua? Just some things about the past, about the war. I've been thinking I missed my chance to find out on what I wanted to know. That old watcher, though, he opens up some new possibilities. I want to ask something about you, if you're sure. I think we asked about all this. I have any family. Just my parents now. They took a ship back to Adir when the purges started. Wanted me to go with them, but I didn't see things like they did. Been a long time since I've seen them. I really should visit, but for some reason I haven't much felt like leaving home. Good thing they chased me out or I might have never left.
What's on your mind? It makes two of us.
Eothas. What is there to know about Eothas?
If you're looking to find religion, maybe you want to start with a god that hasn't been burned to dust, but I won't stop you. Eothas, he was a young man with a silver crown. Carried a candle around with him. Sounds like I'm giving a bad eulogy here.
He was a lot of different things to different people, I guess. Rebirth, redemption, light. Out in the country, he's gone, the farmer, who helps all things pass, seasons and people both. Okay, gone? Okay, because we're using a maze called Gone's Pledge, and we have a Gone's kind of like a bracelet thing. He watches over the weak, does Gone. Sees imbalances made right. You could see why all the copperless rowdies around here might take a liking to someone like that. He was real popular here for a time. These days you won't find too many worshipping Eothas in the open. It's hard to know who still does it in private and who's given up. Feels like I'm the last one sometimes. If that's the case, he deserves all the mourning. I'm surprised he didn't react to anything. What's his name was saying? Do you still worship Eothas?
In my way. I don't suppose he expects me to show up at his temple these days. Not much left to do for him other than keep his memory alive and keep hoping that he's just been playing a joke on all of us these past 15 years.
For as I know, he hasn't sent anything to anybody since the Godhammer detonated. Why worship him then? He grimaces, well, if it turns out he's not dead and I gave up on him, I'd have betrayed my god twice. Even the god of redemption's gotta have standards. I'd probably be reborn as a fat Amawa's horse. That's not really it, though. Not all of it, anyway. He casts a sidelong glance. Yeah, at the priest. Guess it's more I still believe in the things he believed in. I just hope his death doesn't mean the death of those things as well. Sometimes it looks that way. Why did you choose to worship Eothas in the beginning?
Raised that way. My family's been Eothasian going way back. Suppose it wasn't much of a choice at first. Don't know for sure why my family started worshipping him. Probably because of Gon looking after folks like us.
Gon, okay. Not Gon. He looks you in the eye, conspiratorial. Could just as well be that my ancestor did something so bad only Eothas could forgive. Eothas, sorry. It'd explain a lot about where I got some of my less respectable traits. Did you only worship him because that's how you were raised?
Mm-mm. There was something I genuinely liked about Eothas.
Eothas.
Always. Like he understood people better than the other gods.
Can't get it right.
Knew all our flaws and weaknesses and accepted us for that. Folks are at their worst when they're afraid. A god like Eothas, he made you realize there was nothing to fear. Made you a better person. Of course, he goes away for a few years and look what happens.
What made you think Widewind didn't speak for Eothas?
Was his actions. Not when he started his rebellion, and not even when he took over Raed Saris. It was when he sent his armies into Deerwood.
Up to that point, he was sticking up for his people. That's what Eothas does. At least the Gon part of him. part of him. Those farmers were starving, and their government didn't lift a finger. I figured if it wasn't Aethys himself, at least he had the right idea. But then he sent armies across the border, even crossed it himself in the end. Word was, he was chasing refugees that escaped the rebellion. Wanted to punish them, and punish us for allowing them to live here. That just didn't fit for me. Those are the deeds of a vengeful god. Scan, or Wadika, maybe. Not how I say these. Or just a man who lost his sense. I still have trouble believing it, but there's no one left to ask if it's true. Tell me about the purges.
You sure you don't want to talk about something more pleasant? Like the War of Black Trees or the Legacy or something?
Andir looks at you as if he's looking directly into the sun. It's eye-opening, seeing just how naked you are when you've got no god to protect you. The Saints' War was a hard time to be a Deerwooden. People thought it was the end times. They talked big about how we were going to defeat a god, but I don't think there was a man from here to the White March didn't think he was going to die. It does something to you, thinking you're going to die at someone else's hands. There's a rage that comes, indignation. Imagine a whole country full of that. Might have been the Cold Morn that started it, town near the border. They let Widewind march right on through. Rest of Deerwood crushed their names to the end of the war. Cursed their names, sorry. Some say it was the Aethasians there that persuaded the town not to oppose the enemy. Others said it was just cowardice. It was like the Legacy that way. No one knew the real reason, so they just picked whatever one best suited what they wanted to believe. Either way, that town was burning before the first ashes of Aethys hit the ground, and it felt good to the people there. In control. To be in control after being so helpless. So the fire spread. A lot of Aethasians went the way of our god. There were claims from the Church of Magran that she'd actually commanded the purges. I find that hard to believe. Sounded to me like people doing what they wanted, wrapping their god around it, like it was a cloak. Then again, that's what I thought about Widewin.
What's on your mind?
Okay, the interesting thing. Hmm? Can we talk to her?
Hmm?
Hey.
Nope, see, we can't talk to her.
Hi?
See if he has anything new to say, Aloth. Any thoughts on what I should do next? Yeah, I think I've talked to him about that. Well, you're in charge here, and as far as I'm concerned, any place is better than Gilded Vale. His eyes dart to Adir. No offense. We're running late to the episode, and all we did was talk to these guys. I kind of want to see if we can explore something else really quick before we call it an episode.
Got it.
You too, sure. Guy. You're with us.
Steady does it.
What's that? Are we still seeing ghosts like we used to? Wolvie. Looks like it spotted us too, I don't know. Oh, I should have given him a bow.
Yeah.
Kill him as wolf. Oops. Alos, like, he's using that.
Yes?
He's casting something through it, isn't he? Huh.
Eh?
I got a little more to clear out, I can't resist. Oh, these are more of those pillars? Your reflection warps and twists in the live, gleaming Adra. Look how he holds that staff, that's a pretty big staff, pretty long. Oh, who's this? Corpse. He's got a fine greatsword. Put it in a stash here.
How may I help?
Everybody, come on. Now, as far as the stash, kind of like the idea of everybody. Having some kind of range thing going on. He does look a little insane, doesn't he? Should we give him, like, good clothing here? Like, as far as armor? That's one-handed, so I can't give him a shield. And we're out of, what do you call it? Adra formation. We're out of helmets.
Eh?
Everybody. Oh, wait. Didn't mean to hit that. Almost done with the map here. So, this is a long episode. A young boar, huh? Don't bore me with that. I don't think there's gonna be any problem at all.
Eh?
Of course it might have friends. Poor mother. There's a lot more. There's regular boars and young boar now. take down the numbers first. Oops. Yeah. Oh, we're running around this stupid thing.
Lava! Beyond sea!
Man! Okay. Wait, what am I going to? Which one is this last one? It's gonna take me a while to know all those spells, guys. Consecrated ground. Draw on him. Try to make sure everyone's fighting one. Oh no, he's doing
what?
Boars are tough. Oh my god. Wait, no. It's too late for her, isn't it? The stupid thing. A bunch of pigs are killing us. As long as we don't move. But we can't go because we're protected by this thing.
Aztec were Sun Rock. That's it.
Oh man. Bunch of pigs kicked our butt. Boarhide. Boars are infamously temperamental creatures, and despite their size, they are capable of inflicting grievous injuries with their goring tusks. Thick and resistant boar hides fetch good prices at market, while the impressive tusks of elder boars make for even grander prizes.
Of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
Oh, we're almost done, huh? Just camp really quick. Pretty messed up. I really want to just finish this map. We're almost done here. Let's just clear all the fog away. Oh my god. Alright. Okay, oopsie time. While I was fighting the troll, well, we did defeat the thing, but unbeknownst to me, my hard drive is full. Seems I have the audio settings up high, and that I think that made my files a lot bigger than normal, so it's seriously like over 200 gigs for the beginning, from the beginning when we started talking to Durance. So anyway, I'm just about to open fire on this fire troll. Durance has this. Which one is it? Divine Mark. And everyone else is shooting with arrows now. As far as I have messed with the formation, so I've got the two fighters in front. I've got Aloth nice and secure in the middle, a little Aloth sandwich going on, and what do you call it? The cleric and Theodess, Durance and Theodess in the rear. So here we go. Take two. Battle against... What is this? What kind of troll? Forest troll.
Yeah.
So he's gonna go closer to hit it. And he was seen. Okay. We don't want to have him solo. You guys haven't gone yet? Evidently, they're just standing there. I mean, how long does it take to draw an arrow, to knock an arrow and let it fly, right? So, you attack our fighters. Aloth, we'll go with Necrotic Lance this time. Our own Theodas. Amplified thrust on our cleric. Nice. Now, Aloth, I want you to head over this way. We'll do a nice fan of flames on him. She can attack as well. So since he's falling, can the cleric fall back?
How may I help?
Okay. We're doing just fine against him. Has he even gone yet? Alright, so... Fan of flames. Like that. Any other attack spell? I think we're doing fine. I don't think we should buff, because by the time we get to benefit from the buff, we're going to destroy this thing. The He never got to use this, did he? So we'll do that.
Hi. Navarro. Bio.
Takes care of that. It was even easier than the first time, wasn't it? This is troll skin for some reason. When we mouse over, it doesn't tell us. So put that in there. Fulvano's amulet. And golden oval. Chewed letter. Alright, did I read this before? Well, it doesn't matter because we lost that recording. This piece of parchment is torn and flecked with blood and troll spittle. What little of it remains reads, worried he may have come to harm. Once I reach Defiance Bay, I will hire guides to take me back west in safety and see if we cannot find Fulvano. At present, I regret my eagerness to be away from Gilded Vale. It is very dark. Mm-hmm. Now this thing... Fulvano's amulet, so it's a healing bonus. Plus 15% healing done, plus 5 reflex. Though never as famed as he would claim, the Valian explorer Fulvano was known as an eccentric who wished to see the world. Where possible, he traveled by foot to gain a local's appreciation for the sights, sounds, and smells of the lands he passed through. In practice, however, Fulvano often claimed that his explorations proved only that the world outside of the Valian Republics was a foul, smelly place that paled in comparison to his homeland. The amulet is said to have belonged to Fulvano. He was a man very much taken with mild superstitions, and this talisman, he said, was a source of luck. It also served a more sentimental purpose, for it depicts one of the great ships commonly seen at the docks of his homeland. Oh, I mentioned I really love this game, guys, so... Healing... A healing bonus. Now, I'm not sure what this means, that it automatically heals you, or that healing spells you cast are more effective by 15%. Either way, we'll let him do it. I wonder if it would change... Yeah.
What?
Eh? Okay. .20 endurance. Let me just see if it would indicate here. No, it's not what I want.
Hmm.
Same. It says here. Yeah, we'll let him have it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're pretty much all sorted out here. You know that bothers me over there, though. See how there's a little... You never know, there might be a goodie stuck in there. Done. Those little bits don't bother me, but yeah, Magran's fork complete. thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time when we go on to, well, we're gonna either go on to Madmere Bridge, or I'm probably sure, this is like two or three, probably two, I think. At least two more, one or two, I don't know. I have no idea, I'm guessing, guys. I'm not even good at that. So I don't think we're gonna make it to Madmere Bridge next time, but after that. Coming soon. Probably. Hopefully. See you in the next episode, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.